Hey guys and gals, Kevin Baxter at Baxter's Garage and Pro Twin Performance back again. Stick around with us for a couple of minutes. We're going to tell you about this project and another project that means a great deal to us here at the shop. So stay tuned. As many of you may recall, I told the story of Bob McKay and McKay Cycle Creations out of Canada. Bob was a universally respected, world-renowned bike builder, loved husband and father, and to me, a mentor and dear friend. Bob passed away almost a year ago, and he's missed dearly by many. A few months ago, I visited his wife, Diane, to put the last finishing touches on a Tracy body shovel head Bob was building for a customer. That was the last bike that Bob worked on and was the last completed bike to roll out of McKay Cycle Creations. There were two additional projects Bob had started, and I am honored to say I will be completing both of those motorcycles exactly the way he envisioned them. The bike under the sheet over here to my right will remain concealed until completion. Bob started fabrication of that bike in 2009, and it's seen many variations over the years as he and I tossed ideas for it back and forth. It's the very last full custom frame Bob ever fabricated, and in his honor, it will be known as McKay's last creation. As for the second bike, Bob had always been on the lookout for what is known as the Motor Shop single loop frame. He finally found one, and here it is. The Motor Shop was a motorcycle company in Oxnard, California that operated from 1968 to 78. And according to Jim York from the Motor Shop, they had bought a single tube frame or two that was on the market sometime in the early 70s, but he didn't remember who actually made them. They used those as a basis to copy and made their own variation. The Motor Shop frame was unique in that it also had a one-piece top center tube. A company called True Radius Bending in Santa Barbara, California bent the pieces, and a fireman named Bill Denny out of Ventura, California built the jig and did all the welding when he was off duty. He was also a builder of a number of hot rod cars back in the day and had a pretty good name for himself. From 74 to 76, the Motor Shop made less than 100 frames from Bill's memory. The original frame jig was lost after those 2 years as well as the last remaining frame, so Bill never did get a chance to build a bike himself using one of his own frames. Needless to say, these frames are incredibly rare. Bob intended this bike to be an all-business panhead with a four-speed kicker, a clean, simple, basic, period-correct, bare-bones bobber, and that's exactly how I'm going to finish it. We're starting with this S&S panhead. Behind it will be a four-speed kicker from Baker drivetrain, a Morris Magneto, and an open belt primary. There will also be extensive detail work added to the sheet metal you see, and for paint, a style and theme that rolls us back to the mid-70s muscle car and custom chopper era. It'll be known as Stiffy. It's a hard tail and it'll be sexy to look at, so no other name quite fits the bill. Needless to say, I am honored to be able to complete these projects in Bob's memory. He is missed dearly. And this is the best way I can think of to pay tribute to my dear friend and to thank him for helping me in his contributions to the motorcycle industry. So be sure to subscribe and click the bell so you can get updates on these builds as well as all of our other tech videos. So as always, thanks for watching and ride safe.